I'm taking up the second unit of mechanics of machines, that is, the unit is power transmission. See, transmission means power. Whenever we say power, it is mechanical power or motion. Motion, that is power. For whenever a mechanical person says power, it is mechanical power. Whenever an electrical person says power, it is the electrical power. Now, transmission means sending power from one place to another place. That is called as transmission. Like transportation, what we call general in ordinary language as transportation, that is called as transmission here. Now, very commonly, all of us would have seen the transmission of power in a flour mill. We, as urchins, as kids, we all have at least once in our life we have visited a flour mill where you have seen the transmission of power. See, there the motor is rotating, the shaft of the motor rotates. When you switch on a motor, its shaft rotates. That motion of the shaft of motor is to be given or is to be transmitted to the shaft of the mill. You have seen that they have mounted two pulleys on these two shafts and they pass an endless belt over it. Endless belt is passed and the power is transmitted from the motor to the mill shaft, motor shaft to the mill shaft. This is a very common example for mechanical power transmission, which all of us would have seen. Now, this is called as power transmission. Like there are different modes of transportation. Like you can transport things by road, you can transport it by air, you can transport it by rail. Similarly, mechanical power can be transmitted from one place to another place by different means, like belts. These are the means used: belts, ropes, chains, gears, etc. Now, we have in our syllabus, we have transmission belt by ropes and by gears. These three we have. We don't have the other things. These three we have. Now, you will get numericals in this. In this chapter, you will get numericals. So, I will first start with the rope drive. Belt drive. I will start with belt drive. If a belt is used for transmission of power, then it is called as a belt drive. The drive is called as belt drive. Belt drive means we are transmitting power from one shaft to another by using a belt. Then the drive is called as belt drive. Now, I told you the very common place where you use this belt drive is in a flour mill. You use it in these two-wheelers also, you use belt drive. So many places we can see belt drive. Here, a belt is used. Now, there are two types of belts used. They are the flat belt and the V belt. We use two types of belts to transmit power by means of a belt. That is, one is flat belt and the other one is V belt. Now, you are familiar with this. The flat belt means its section is rectangular. It is of rectangular section. This is called as its width and this is called as its thickness. The thickness is very, very small in comparison with its width. So that is called as a flat belt. This is V belt, will be trapezoidal in section. This is made from different materials, that is made from the different materials. This runs on a flat pulley, this runs on a groot pulley. You use groot pulley here. These differences, the materials are different. This comes in standard sizes. This you can have any size you want, you can cut it. You use fasteners to connect the two ends. So these are some of the differences, major differences between flat belt and V belt. Now, the numerical normally comes in the flat belt. Normally, you get a problem, you can get a problem on flat belt drive. Now what are the possible problems that we can get? We can get problems on velocity ratio. You can get problem on velocity ratio. Velocity ratio, then finding length of belt, finding width of belt, that is this width, then power, finding power transmitted by a belt, there can be a problem. In addition to this, we use one more relationship called the tension ratio. On this, there will not be a direct problem, but this we will use in these problems. Whenever we want something connected with these things, we will use this. So these are the five important formulae that come in the discussion of flat belt. Now we will take one by one these five things. Velocity ratio means it is the ratio of angular velocity of driven shaft or driven pulley, they say both are same because pulley and the shaft will rotate at same velocity. Angular velocity of driven pulley to the ratio of angular velocity of driven pulley to the angular velocity of driver pulley. This is called as the velocity ratio. This ratio is what we call the velocity ratio. Here you see, I told you the example of a flour mill. The motor shaft is the driver shaft. It is the shaft which is giving the power. The shaft which gives the power is called as the driver, and the shaft which receives the power is called as the driven or the follower. You can also call it as follower. Right. Now this will be equal to omega 2 by omega 1. You know, omega is the symbol that you have used for angular velocity in science. And this will be also equal to n2 by n1, that is RPM, speed in RPM, because omega is 2 pi n by 60 radians. This is angular velocity. Now here also you get 2 pi by 60, here also you get 2 by pi by 60, they cancel. So you can write it as n2 by n1. Now we can prove that this velocity ratio n2 by n1 can be proved to be equal to d1 by d2. That is n1 d1 will be equal to n2 d2 when the thickness of belt, that is small t, and slip, that is S, are neglected. When these two are neglected, then the velocity ratio becomes n2 by n1 is equal to d1 by d2. Here the n2 means the speed of the driven pulley, 2 stands for driven, 1 stands for driver. So d1 means dia of the driver pulley, d2 means dia of the driven pulley. So when you cross multiply, it will be n2 d2 is equal to n1 d1. Here 4 quantities are connected. If we know any 3 of them, the 4th quantity can be calculated if this is the condition. Then in case we consider thickness, if belt thickness is considered, we don't neglect it. It is given in the problem, means we have to consider it. If belt thickness is considered, is considered, then what will happen? This will be equal to, velocity ratio will be equal to N2 by N1 is equal to D1 plus T divided by D1 plus T divided by D2 plus T. Here, if I have considered only belt thickness is considered, I have neglected the slip. Slip means the difference between velocity of belt and velocity of pulley is called as, there will be some difference between the two, that is called as the slip. It will be 3%, 4%, like that they will give. Now, if that is neglected and thickness is considered, if this and that both are considered, if belt thickness and slip both are considered, then what will happen is this formula will be further 100 minus S divided by 100, where this S is the percentage slip. So this is the, these three equations you get. One is neglecting both belt thickness and this thing, another one if only thickness is considered, and another one is considering both slip and thickness. They can give a problem on this such a way that one of the diameter is to be calculated, three times it has to be calculated. You get almost very close to each other answers, but you will not get same answer in all the three cases. So the formulae that we get are, these are the formulae that you get. Here, I will tell you what is, you have to note down what is N1, N2, what they stand for. N1 is speed of, 1 means driver pulley in RPM, driver speed of driven, or you can take it as follower pulley in RPM. Then similarly, D1 stands for diameter of driver, 1 stands for driver pulley. I am not giving the unit, they should all be in the same unit. D2 is dia of driven pulley. Both should be in the same unit. They can be mm, centimeter, meter, anything, but both should be in the same unit. Then T is thickness of belt. This also must be in the same unit as these two diameters. And S is the slip, percentage slip. Percentage slip, this will, if it is given, you have to take it into consideration. So these are the notations. So these are the formulae. They can ask you to find the fourth quantity three times. Same quantity you will have to find out three times. Next comes a problem on length of belt. Second one is problem on finding length of belt. Now the length of belt depends upon whether it is open belt drive. There are two types of drives. One is called open belt drive and the other one is called crossed belt drive. Now open belt drive means it comes like this. This is one pulley, this is the other pulley, they are connected like this, the belt passes like this, then the belt drive is called as open belt drive. Here both the pulleys rotate in the same direction. If they are rotating in this, if you want them to rotate both to rotate in same direction, you will connect it like this. This is called as open belt drive. Here, this is called R1, radius of the bigger pulley. This is called R2, the radius of smaller pulley. We don't mind which is driver and which is driven here. This is the center distance, the distance between the two pulleys. Now, we have to find what is the length of the belt required. Now, the formula for that is open belt, length of open belt will be equal to pi into R1 plus R2 plus 2C. It depends upon the values of R1, R2 and C, plus R1 minus R2 the whole square divided by 2C. This is the formula that gives you the open belt, the length of open belt drive. R1 is the radius, not the diameter, it is the radius of larger of the two pulleys, larger pulley. Again, I am not giving unit here because it can be either in mm or in centimeter or in meter. All three should be in the same unit and you get the answer also in the same unit. They should not be substituted in different units. Radius of smaller pulley, C is center distance, distance between centers, between centers of two pulleys, centers of pulleys, all in same units. All the three must be in the same unit. If all are in mm, you get the length of the belt in mm. If all are in centimeter, we will get the length in centimeter. If all are substituted in meter, we get the length in meters, like that. The second one is the cross belt drive. Say the same thing is, we want them to rotate in opposite direction, then they will be connected like this. This is one pulley, this is another pulley. The belt is passed this way. The belt, if you pass the belt this way, then if this is rotating in clockwise direction, this will be rotating in anti-clockwise direction. So you will get like that. Same formula, same notations, you have the same notations. It is called the crossed belt drive. Here the notation is same, units also same. The formula changes like this. Length of crossed belt, LC, will be pi into R1 plus R2 plus 2C plus R1 plus R2 square divided by 2C. This is the formula for this, for cross belt, and this is the formula for the open belt. So this formula you have to know. Again, R1 stands for radius of the larger pulley, R2 stands for the radius of the smaller pulley, and C is the distance, center distance between the two pulleys. Right. For the same value of R1, R2 and C, the length of the cross belt will be greater than the length of the open belt, and sometimes they will give a problem like this. First, he will say it is connected by cross belt, then what is the length, he will ask. Then he will say, I want to shift to open belt, so how much length is to be reduced? Then you have to find by this formula, and this minus this will give you the length to be reduced or length to be cut, length of the belt to be cut to shift from cross belt to open belt drive. So this is the on length of belt. Next, finding width of belt. Third one, finding width of belt. Width of belt, that is B, it is denoted by B or W, whatever it is. Now here, whenever width of belt is asked, they will give the stress of the permissible stress of the belt material. In strength of materials, we have seen that stress is load by area. Here the load is, there will be, when a belt is passed over this thing, when it is transmitting power, it will be subjected to a tensile load or tensile force. It is not called as load, it is called as tension. Now, one side it is called as T1 and the other side it will be called as T2. One side it will be higher, the force is acting will be greater, that is called as T1, and this side is called as the this side is called as the tight side. It is called as the tight side, and the other one is called as the slack side. They are called as slack side. Slack side. Now, we will always design it for the tight side, the higher tension. The tension will be higher, so load will be, this is F, load will be T1, that is tension on tight side, divided by area of cross section will be width into thickness. So from here you will get B is equal to T1 divided by F into T. This is the formula for calculating the width of the width of the belt. Here T1 is tension on tight side. Tension on tight side. Tight side in Newton. In Newton, F is permissible stress of belt material in Newton per mm square. Newton per mm square. And T is thickness of belt. Thickness of belt in mm. If you put these in these units, you are going to get the width of belt. Width of belt you will get in millimeters. Now, in case this is neglected, if T is neglected, what will happen? If T is neglected, sometimes it is neglected, it is not given. Then, if T is neglected, thickness of belt is neglected, it is very small, so it can be neglected. Then what will happen is B will be equal to T1 divided by F. Now this F now is permissible stress in permissible stress in the belt material. It will be given in Newton per mm width. It will not be given as mm square. If it is given as Newton per mm square, that means we have to take thickness into consideration. If it is given as Newton per mm width, then you have to neglect this thickness, and it will not be given in the problem. In that case, you will have to do it like that, using this formula. Either by this formula or by that formula, you will get the width of the this thing, depending upon how the problem is given. Next is the tension ratio. Now, in tension ratio, fourth one is tension ratio. We will not get a problem on this, but we will use this in other problems. Now, this tension ratio is the ratio of tension on tight side, tension on tight side, which is always greater than, greater, divided by tension on slack side. It is a ratio of tension on tight side to slack side. Its value will be always greater than 1, because the numerator is always greater than the denominator. So this is denoted by T1 by T2. Mathematically, this we can prove. You don't have proof for this, but we can prove it as t to the power t1 by t2 is equal to e to the power of mu theta. Now this relationship is called as the tension ratio relationship. From this we generally use find out t1 by t2, or to get t1 in terms of t2 we can use this. Here in this equation we'll be using it, tension on tight side, tension on tight side of the belt in Newton. This is tension on slack side, on slack side, tension on slack side again in Newton. E is a Napierian base, Napierian base, that's a constant. Mu is coefficient of friction, coefficient of friction between belt and pulley, between belt and pulley. And theta is angle of contact between belt and smaller pulley, always smaller pulley in radians. This is important. It will be given in degrees. We have to convert it into radians, in radians. So the angle of contact means here on the smaller pulley, this angle which is in contact with the belt, it is called angle of embrace, angle of contact, etc., etc. So it means the same thing. Here it will be greater than 180 degrees. Here it will be less than 180 degrees. If it is open belt, it will be less than 180 degrees. If it is cross belt, it will be more than 180 degrees. If theta is not directly given, it can be found out. If we know R1, R2 and C, we can find it out. This theta will be equal to 180 minus 25 degrees in case of open belt drive. And theta will be 180 plus 25 degrees in case of crossed belt drive. If it is crossed belt drive, it will be bigger, more than 180. Here, this phi is angle made by the belt. By the belt with the line through centers of the pulleys in degrees. That means this angle here, this is phi here. If you take it out, this angle is called as phi. Now, how to find this angle? That angle again can be found out. If we know R1, R2 and C, this angle will be sine inverse of R1 minus R2 divided by 2C. So many degrees in case of open belt drive. And this will be sine inverse of R1 plus R2 divided by 2C in case of so many degrees in case of crossed belt drive. So this you must know. In case theta is not given, they will give R1, R2 and C will be given, then we can get theta if it is not given. But if theta is known only, we can get the relationship between T1 and T2, or we can get T1 in terms of T2. So this is the fourth relationship that you get. Then the fifth relationship is power transmitted by a belt. Now this is given by, power transmitted by a belt is given by the formula P is equal to T1 minus T2 into V divided by 1000, so many kilowatts. This is the formula for calculating power. Here T1 is the tension on tight side. Same, already we know it. Tension on tight side in Newton. Tight side in Newton. T2 is tension on slack side in Newton. And V is velocity of belt. Velocity of belt in meters per second. Now this can be found out by the formula pi d n by 60, so many meters per second. Here d is dia of pulley, any one pulley you can take, dia of pulley in meters, and n is speed of same pulley. Speed of which dia you have taken, which pulley dia you have taken, the same pulley speed you have to take, speed of the same pulley in RPM. So that gives you V. It can be either D1 N1 or it can be D2 N2. Any one can be taken. So this formula gives you the power transmitted by a belt. These are the formulae that you have to know.